Hey, party people. Andrew here at SHOT 2024, hanging out with David at the Strike Industries booth. You guys always bringing it with all kinds of new crazy stuff. You are, as a company, very innovative and imaginative even. One of the things that you've made a while back, not new, you guys knew about it a while ago, that was one of those things that should have been done years ago, is that universal mounting plate for little red dot, mini, micro, whatever, little red dots.
Yeah, we've applied that optic mounting pattern to virtually everything we have, whether it's a T1, T2 riser or for our light slides. We have it for a lot of different products, a lot of product categories.
That should have been done a long time ago. There are far too many standards out there, and I love the fact that your mount lets people put whatever sight on whatever thing. It should have been that way from the beginning.
For sure.
What do I got here? Aside from Stargate LARPing.
This is the Strike P90 chassis. Let's work our way from the back to the front. It's just a prototype, but it's pretty exciting.
You want to touch my butt?
So the length of the pull of the stock is going to be adjustable. We've got QD points on the front and the back end, both sides, I believe. Yes. And for your cheek rest, it is a riser with three adjustable points, so three different heights. Moving forward, we have a fore end that has a 12 o'clock and 6 o'clock Picatinny rail. We've got M-lock slots at the 3, 9, 10, and 2 positions, so you can just mount a stupid amount of accessories to this. Laser, IR, weapon mount of light.
Two lasers, four lasers.
All the lasers.
All the lasers. You could do the Predator thing with the three dots.
The three dots, yes, you can, yeah. You can have a traditional P90 optics mount there as well. And there's a pick rail on the 9 o'clock. Yeah, and right here.
It's occupied.
Yeah, if you want to apply it to the 3 o'clock, it'll still work. But whether you have a PS90, the P90, the SBR version, it's going to work with this chassis, guys. Now going back to the grip, I think you'll notice that the grip is extremely comfortable. If you want to just shoulder that real quick, you might notice that the angle is more modern. It's a 70 degree angle. The traditional thumb hole stock of the P90 is interesting.
It's interesting.
It's a more aggressive angle. I believe it's 20 degrees, about that much. So it is, yeah, if you add our fore-end, any of our curved links or fore-end grips, it's going to be incredibly ergonomic and very comfortable.
Well, if nothing else, this part of it takes a little bit away from the goofy 16-inch barrel on the PS90, because we have to comply with the NFA and all that.
At a glance, it almost looks like the battle rifle.
Yeah, Halo style. Yeah. I could dig it. Yeah. I love this style of all of your products are aesthetically right in my vibe. I love it.
Great. Yeah. Well, a lot of us are gamers, so I can't say that there aren't inspirations from, you know, certain things in that genre and culture.
As it should be. Look, a big, enormous part of the reason for the expansion in the industry that we work in and the hobby that we all enjoy is from video games. I mean, people, the boomers, will talk crap in the forums and whatnot because, of course, they're on the forums because they're boomers. But, like, they'll talk crap about, oh, you know, Call of Duty isn't real life. Well, you know what? Call of Duty is fun. And you know what else isn't real life? Poker or basketball. But they're also fun. Games are fun. And when games can also integrate guns and we can get some of the cool sci-fi vibes out of the games into the guns, it's a win for everybody.
Yeah, we're incredibly excited about this. Our oppressor, it's a concussion reduction device, also known as a blast forwarding device. The inner diameter of that forend is going to be able to fit. It's going to be able to see in there. Cool. Along with a variety of suppressors.
Nice.
Yeah. So
what do you got here?
This is the Bravo. This is the SMC Bravo, the second iteration of our SMC series. This fits specifically a P320 FCU, and this one is riddled with just a bunch of Strike accessories. So again, we'll start from the back. This is our FSA dual adapter. It can be a stabilizer or a stock. We've got a single folder on the way. You just press the left button to go right, the right button to go left. You push it up a little bit, like a millimeter, and it comes back out. Moving forward, we have the P320 spare mag holder here. This is our hyper shield, the blast shield. We also have a shorter one. We call that the standard. And then here we have a ambidextrous modular P320 charging handle. So you can install it to the left or to the right. You're welcome, lefties. We have the extended magazine release here. And that about does it for the Bravo.
Can I see it?
Of course.
Awesome. So the only SIG parts on this are going to be the fire control group and the slide.
That's
everything
correct.
Else is Strike Industries or Surefire in this case.
Yeah, correct. We also have the extended mag plates. So that's a SIG one, so this one. Yeah, that's a SIG 30 rounder, but in the front we have an extended mag plate that strikes aluminum extended mag plus 5 rounds.
Okay.
And it is only legal for open division if you're shooting USPSA.
I love it. All right, so next up, this is the thing I was really excited about. This is your new micro red dot, right?
No, that's a thermal. Yeah.
So explain to me what's going on. Obviously, I joke because of course it's pretty big,
yeah.
But it's big because this is basically two sights in one unit here,
yes.
Right?
Yes, it's a red dot with overlaid on top of a thermal optic. We're calling it the Cyclops by Hexion Tech and Strike Industries. So the red dot is powered by one CR2032, and the thermal sight is powered by two CR123As. What makes this special, guys, is that it's got the highest resolution in class and in the industry. It's got a multicolor and multi-reticle system. So there's no one else in the industry doing that right now. If you hold the plus and minus signs, you can toggle between the different reticles. And with the AI enhanced tech we have in this, you can cycle through different thermal options. You can prioritize a highlight feature where you highlight your objects and targets, or you can select prioritization for outlining your targets and objects that you're looking at.
Oh, so you could actually have more than one point of aim in here too, huh?
That is correct.
I see there's a green little semicircle that's
yeah.
not at the center. Then the
correct.
The red overlay is not at the center of the amber crosshairs.
I'm really glad you noticed that, because that little half circle is a ranging tool. So you can zero it. Let's say you want to zero that for 50 yards or 100 yards, but maybe your red dot is zeroed at something else, like typical combat zero.
50 meter
yeah.
battle sight zero, right?
Yep.
That's pretty cool. So we're seeing white hot, but we're also getting edge detection. Is that what I'm?
Yeah, you'll outline figures of people and also objects you're seeing. So whether that's a table, a person, somebody's pants, you'll see a lot of details.
That's amazing. I don't know what that guy ate for lunch, but he needs to chill out in this booth. I'm kidding. I don't know if you can even see farts through this thing. Do me a favor, and I know some of this is not quite ready,
mm-hmm.
But as best you can tell us, can you
sure.
tell us when these things are going to be available and how much we'll have to pay?
So with Strike, you know, we always want to be affordable, fun, and a price leader. I don't have exact numbers for that yet, but I can tell you that the fact that we got it here to SHOT Show is huge already. So we're hoping to see something this year.
This year?
This year.
Okay. What about our Bravo and the P90 chassis?
So for the Bravo, it's actually available now, guys. We actually already fulfilled all the pre-orders. So if you guys, by the time you guys see this video, you should be, if you pre-ordered it, you should be receiving it in your front door right now.
Oh, that's nice.
The official launch is actually after SHOT, just because we were so busy with the event. But in terms of the P90 chassis, also, we hope this year.
Okay. What's the MSRP going to look like on the Bravo and the P90?
Well, the Bravo right now is retailing for $129.95, and we can expect other similar chassis coming out that we shared prototypes with on Instagram to be around the same thing. The P90 chassis is a lot larger, so we don't have an MSRP for that just yet.
There's some more material there?
Yeah.
Well, thank you, sir. I appreciate you putting up with my crap.
Thanks for coming by.
Thank you guys for watching. I love you.